Hello guys, welcome to another lecture by Supreme Tuber. In this lecture we will be studying k-map for three variable. I will be teaching you k-map for three variable through a question. Okay, so I'll write the question now. So suppose this is the question. Okay, simplify the boolean expression f of x y z. I'll write z this way, I hope you don't mind, is equal to x dash dot y dot z plus x dash dot y dot z dash plus x dot y dash dot z dash plus x dot y dash dot z using Karnaugh map. Okay, so if it wasn't written k map, you can also simplify the expression using boolean algebra, but since it is written k map and I have to teach k map, we will be using three variable k map. So as there are three variables, so the number of cells in the table will be 2 to the power 3 8. Okay, so the table will look like this, Karnaugh map. You don't call it table, you call it Karnaugh map. Sorry for calling it table. Okay, so it has 8 cells. Okay, here you will write x, which means this side will represent x terms, and here you will write yz, which means this side will represent yz terms. Okay, so the first which comes is x dash, then x, here it comes y dash dot z dash, y dash dot z, y dot z, y dot z dash. Okay, so this is a pattern which you have to learn. First you will take y dash and you will write two different configurations of z, then you will take y and you write two different configurations of z again. Okay, so now you will fill out these four elements in this table. Okay, in their respective cells. I will be teaching you sum of product SOP forms. POS will be covered in later lectures. Okay, so the first term is x dash dot y dot z, x dash, which means this row, and y dot z means this column. Okay, so the cell is this. We will write one. Okay, here the next element is x dash dot y dot z dash. X dash means this row again, y dot z dash means y dot z dash, this element y dot z dash. So we put a one here. The next element is x dot y dash dot z, x. Okay, so this row, these four cells are included. Y dash dot z dash means these two cells, the intersection of these two is this cell. Okay, the next element is x dot y dot z, x means this row, y dot z means this column. Okay, so the element is this. So after writing all the elements in the three variable k-map, you will group these terms. Okay, you have to form the largest possible group so that the this expression is minimized to its best possible form. Okay, so you can see we can have a two pairs here. You could also have formed, like, I'll use a different pen to tell you. Remember, what I'm drawing now is incorrect. You could have also done that, but in that case the answer will not be simplified. Okay, let's suppose I draw four singlets here. Okay, I am using a green color pen to tell you. Okay, so this is wrong. Okay, the function will not be simplified this way, it will come the exact same which it was. So what is the use of drawing? The use of drawing k-map is to simplify the expression. For simplifying the expression, you have to take the maximum possible terms. Okay, so the simplified expression of this k-map will include these two pairs. Let's name this pair 1, let's name this pair 2. Okay, pair 1 is equal to x dot y dash dot z dash plus x dot y dash dot z. You can also write pair 1 directly, but if it comes in exam for like 2 or 3 marks, you have to simplify pair 1 and pair 2. You can't just write pair 2, pair 1's value directly. You have to show them simplified form. Okay, so you can take x dot y dash is common here and common here. Okay, z plus z dash, which equals to x dot y dash. So pair 1 is equal to x dot y dash. Okay, similarly pair 2 is equal to x dash dot y dot z plus x dash dot y dot z dash. Okay, x dash dot y dot I'll write it. You can see here x dash dot y is common here. Okay, so I'll take x dash dot y common, z plus z dash is 1. Okay, and any number x dot any number multiplied with 1 is same in Boolean algebra as well. So this comes out to be pair 2. Okay, so the simplified form of this function, f simplified x y z is equal to pair 1 plus pair 2, therefore x dot y dash plus x dash dot y. Okay, so this is the simplified form of this k-map. Okay, so I'll take one more question so that you can clear the concept very clearly. Okay, so let's suppose this is the question: simplify the Boolean function, this function, using k-map. Okay, you can see that the function is a three variable function a, b, c, but in the expression some terms have only two elements, a, b. C is missing here, a is missing. So for these type of questions there is a trick. Okay, there is a trick. Let's suppose we will write f again. F is a dot b dot c plus c dash is 1. Okay, so you can multiply c plus c dash, okay, by this term. Okay, so that c is introduced in this term and we can draw the k map easily. In this term a is missing, so you will multiply by a plus a dash, okay, dot b dot c, and in this element all the terms are present, so you will leave it as it is. Okay, this is the first step. When all the terms, when you know the number of variables and all the number of variables are not appearing in all the elements, okay, three variables are not appearing in all the elements, then this is the first step. Okay, so now you can use distributive law. A dot b dot c plus a dot, sorry, a dash dot b dash dot c plus a dash dot b dash dot c dash. Okay, I'll write it. Okay, so this term is broken down, sorry, is expanded in this term, these two terms. This term is expanded into these two terms and this is left as it is. Okay, so you can see here, so this is our expression for which we have to draw k-map. Okay, now for drawing k-map, the number of elements are 3, so the number of cells will be 2 to the power 3 is equal to 8. Okay, so I'll draw the k-map here. Three variable k-maps are drawn like this. Okay, A will be represented this side and BC will be represented. Writing A here means these terms will be in A terms and these will be BC terms. Okay, so A dash A, B dash C dash, B dash dot C, B dot C, B dot C dash. Okay, now we will fill out these five elements: A dash dot B dash dot C, A dash, sorry, this was A dash dot B dash dot C dash. Now the next term is a dash dot b dash dot c, a dash dot b dash dot c, a dot b dot c, a dot b dot c. Okay, a dash dot b dot c, a dash dot b dot c. Okay, the next term is a dash dot b dot c dash, a dash dot b dot c, sorry, a dash dot b dot c dash. Okay, so this will be our k-map. Okay, so now we have to group the terms such that the largest group is possible. Here you can see, you can group these four together. I'll use a different pen to group them. You can group these four together, okay, to form the largest pair. You could have also formed a pair, two pairs like this, but you have to form the largest possible pair to simplify the function to its full potential. Okay, now we have, for including this element, you can either form a singlet or you can form a pair like this. A pair is beneficial, okay, because it simplifies the function better. Ultimately, what is our goal? Our goal is to simplify the function, na? Okay, so you can write this as quad 1 and you can write this as pair 1. Okay, pair 1 is equal to a dot b dot c plus a dash dot b dot c, which when simplified becomes b dot c. You can take a and a dash cancels. Okay, a and a plus, cos a plus a dash is equal to 1. Now for quad 1, it is a dash plus b dash dot c dash plus a dash dot b dash dot c, okay, plus a dash dot b dot c. plus a dash dot b dot c dash. All these four elements are represented. Remember, I am only writing this in the expanded form so that you can understand them well. In exam, you don't have to write this if it is in less marks, but if it is in more marks, you have to write. You can see relative, you are grown enough, I presume. Okay, so simplifying this will become, you can see that a dash is common in all these. A dash, all these terms will cancel out when you take common. I'm not taking common. Okay, so f simplified will become, I'll write it here so that I don't have to use next page. F simplified will become the sum of quad 1 plus pair 1. The quad 1 is a dash, pair 1 is b dot c. Okay, so this term is simplified to this. Okay, this is simplified to this. So this was three variable k-map. If you like the video, do like, share and comment and subscribe to my channel. And if you have any doubt, post them in the comment section. I'll be more than happy to help. Thank you guys for watching the video.